Hey guys, I wanted to show y'all how I make my, I don't really have a name for it, but I bake a chicken in my crock pot one day, and Shane and I can usually get 2 to 3 other meals out of it. We'll probably only get 2 meals out of this one. It is a bit smaller. I bought a 5-pound, ignore my sink, by the way. I bought a 2 to 3 pound chicken at Kroger. I didn't pay more than $6 for it. I can't remember the exact price, but the ticket's under there. But anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to roast it in my crock pot, and I'm going to show you the seasoning method that I do. In my crock pot, I put foil in the very bottom, and that keeps it from actually like cooking in its juice. A lot of the juice will run at the bottom, so it actually does roast and bake if it were in the oven. So I'm just going to show y'all how I do these little foil balls. I just take regular aluminum foil, and I probably do a pretty good square sheet, and then I just drop it right in there. Now you may have to push down a little bit on them and kind of flatten them out, but don't do too much because then your chicken will sit in your juice. And some of it will sit in the juice, but that's totally fine. I like the breast of the chicken to be a little drier, so this is perfect. This is the perfect method for me. Okay, I'm going to show you how we do the seasonings right now. I already have ground black pepper in here because this pepper thing is really annoying and it takes forever. So I keep it pretty simple. I'm just gonna do regular salt, Italian seasoning, and this is a personal preference. We like Italian seasoning, and it gives really good flavor, especially to chicken. Be careful with that. Here I have poultry seasoning as well. I'm gonna do just a smidge of that garlic powder, and I don't skimp on this. I really, really like garlic powder. Probably not the best brand, but it does the trick. Just a tiny bit of paprika. It gives it such a pretty golden brown color once it's done. And because I'm from Louisiana, you can't beat Tony's Sasheries.
Tony's always working.
Shane puts it on every single thing he eats. See, that's our seasoning mixture. I'm just going to mix it with my hands. Now, I used to take something like this and mash it into a softened stick of butter, which is really good, and I suggest that if you have it to do it, because then you can put it underneath the skin. Just cut, once the butter gets cold again, you can cut it and put it underneath the skin, and as it cooks, it really melts back down into the chicken. The seasoning package used to require oil, so I just got used to that method. It was pretty easy. So I'm just going to use my hand again, clean hands. I just washed them after moving my chicken over here. And it looks like a good bit of oil, but it's totally worth it because this is going to give your chicken all its flavor. I went ahead and kind of tried to loosen up my chicken some, but I'm going to do it some more. And don't forget to go right here. There's a little pocket where you can get right here over that drumstick. And you really want to get in there. Okay, so I'm just getting all this. I'm going up under the skin and then all on top of the skin. And then what you can do, it's just pour it. I'm not really worried about the underside because as this cooks, the juices will go down underneath there and take care of all that for me. So that is basically it. And I want to keep it kind of neutral. That way it does transition over better. This is step one in a chicken makeover meal. I hope you enjoy every single meal that I prepare from this one chicken, or at least give you an idea of ways that you can extend your meals. Like I said, this chicken was not over $6. And I plan to get 3 meals out of it. So we'll see what happens. Usually it always works out. We may not have leftovers from one of the meals, but that's okay. We'll live. Hey guys, so we're back home from church, and I realized that we didn't have quite as much time to leave the chicken in the crock pot. Normally I can put it on high, depending on how big it is. It usually cooks in about 2 to 2.5 hours. I'm used to the chickens that have the little plug in them that pops up. Kroger doesn't have those, but if you do want those, Winn-Dixie has them, and they usually have a Cajun seasoning from Paul Prudhomme in them, and they're really good. That's the Cajun seasoning I like to use. But anyway, so I got home, I took it out of the crock pot, I put it in the oven at 400. It's probably been in there for what, like 10 minutes?
Yeah.
So I've been there about 10 minutes right now. I just set the timer for another 15, which it kind of worked out. We are eating really late. Shane and I eat really early, but usually on Sundays and Wednesdays, we eat dinner pretty late, so that's okay. Some really nice church members gave me some zucchini and some squash. So I have those sauteing. Right now I just have them in olive oil. I've got a little onion in there. I'm going to put salt and pepper, and usually I'll do fresh garlic, but today I'm probably just going to put some garlic powder in right at the end.
probably put a little pat of butter. We are in the South. If you read my apron, it's my favorite apron. It says, put some South in your mouth. This is a Paula Deen special. If you don't like Paula Deen, you're on the wrong channel. I also have some corn going back here. I'm going to give you a little tip about buying fresh corn. Try to find corn that's in the husk still. I bought this at Piggly Wiggly probably about 2 weeks ago. And it's been 2 weeks, so I decided to just go ahead and cook what I have left. Shane will eat it. He loves corn. If you have a husband that doesn't like vegetables, I highly suggest that you try this squash and zucchini mixture, especially if you put butter in it. Another suggestion is bacon grease. That's how I got Shane to start eating vegetables. He did not like to eat vegetables until I started putting a little bit of bacon grease, and then I just have an old coffee can, and every time I cook bacon, I just take the lid off, pour it in there, and let it sit until it kind of cools off, and then I put it in the fridge, and that's how I store it. Anyway, we're going to have some rolls with this as well, and our chicken, and I'm really looking forward to showing you the rest of the meals that we're going to get out of this one chicken that I paid $5.44 for. I found the receipt. $5.44 for a whole fryer is what it is. And it was probably about 2 to 3 pounds, may have been closer to 4 pounds, considering that it's taken so long to cook. Because we were also pressed for time, we had to make a stop at Walmart before we came home, so I decided to give the steaming mashed potatoes a try, and I've heard they're really good. I like to jazz mine up a good bit, so I think I can make them work. Either way, they're russet potatoes, which is what I like to use for mashed potatoes. Shane also likes really chunky mashed potatoes, so I think that this will give him the kind of consistency. We don't eat
instant
mashed potatoes in our house.
Not in this house.
I would eat instant mashed potatoes, and I have eaten them, and I like them. They make potato dish spread, but he buys the grocery, so what he says goes. Hey guys, I wanted to show you really fast just what I did with my chicken after it had cooled. My chicken isn't in the fridge for probably about 2 days now. I cooked it on Sunday. Today's Tuesday. So I waited till it was cool because I find it's a little easier to pull the chicken meat apart. It kind of stays together instead of like shredding and spreading apart. So I don't have to pick as much. But I flip it all different ways to make sure I get as much meat as possible. And I try to clean everything off pretty good. I also wanted to show y'all. This is all the chicken meat I got, and I split it. So this bowl has a lot of white meat in it. This is what I'm going to use for baked chicken chimichangas. I've seen them pinned several times on Pinterest. I also had them in one of my boards, so I'm going to give those a try. And then this chicken has a lot of the dark meat because it's going to be a major filler for spinach and chicken stuffed manicotti. I wanted to do stuffed shells, but we went to a small grocery store right around the corner. They didn't have the shells, so I bought the manicotti noodles instead. I hope you guys stay tuned to see what's next. Thanks. Bye. Hey guys, I'm about to run into town, so I thought while I was running some errands, I would go ahead and get my baked chicken chimichangas prepped and ready to go. For those of you that are working moms or just really busy stay-at-home moms, I would suggest doing this the night before, maybe after your kids go to bed or you're just kind of winding down. And I like for everything to have some time to incorporate together, kind of meld together in flavor. So what I'm going to do is I forgot to take my cream cheese out. I kind of wasn't going to do this, and then I decided I was going to do it. Since my cream cheese is still pretty cold, I'm going to go ahead and pop it in the microwave. I'm going to put it in this Tupperware. I'm going to mix everything in this Tupperware bowl. That way I can put it right in the fridge. Okay, so I warmed up my cream cheese for about 30 seconds at 10-second intervals. I got this recipe from Pinterest, and of course I'll link it below. But it says to stir together cream cheese, pepper jack cheese, and taco seasoning, and then add your chicken. So I just buy the off-brand Best Choice pepper jack cheese. You could always use Mexican blend cheese if you want to, but I decided it was on sale. This calls for pepper jack cheese, so I'm going to do that. The recipe only calls for 8 ounces, so that's a cup. And then 1.5 tablespoons of taco seasoning. Glad I read that because I totally thought I was going to have to pour this whole thing in here, and that would have been really bad. So, if you're worried about wasting, know that I'm going to use some of this in my Spanish rice recipe. Okay, so before I add our chicken, I'm going to stir all this together. So the recipe calls for 1 pound of cooked chicken shredded. This is my chicken from the chicken I cooked Sunday. As you saw a little while ago, how I did all that. But anyway, it's shredded for the most part. I'm okay with that. This may be a little more than a pound. Just do whatever suits your family. I mean, if you have a family of four, you probably want to maybe up this recipe by half. I wouldn't quite double it. Because this is supposed to make 8 chimichangas. And I only have, I think, like 6 tortillas, but they're the big tortillas. So it may work out. Okay, that's not working. Okay, so here's my mixture. Pretty big Tupperware. It's full. I'm going to pop the lid on and put it in the fridge. That's it for now. Alright guys, I'm going to show you how to make homemade Spanish rice. There's many different ways that you can do it. I'm just going to show you my way. I'm starting with, in this saucepan back here, I'm going to add 1.5 cups of water and 8 ounces. Make sure I'm not lying. Of what?
Make it come closer.
Oh. 8 ounces of tomato sauce. And again, best choice. I don't discriminate against off brands at all. Add to that 1/4 chopped onion. Whoops. Oh gosh. Whole garlic clove. Now you can add 2 cups of water and 1/2 cup of salsa. This is just the way I'm going to do it because I actually don't have any salsa. In this skillet right here, I just have about 1 tablespoon, maybe a little bit more, of all natural Luana coconut oil. I like this kind of coconut oil because it's refined, which means it doesn't have as much of a coconut taste. I'm allergic to coconut. It makes me really sick. So this is what I can have. You can use vegetable oil. I just don't keep vegetable oil in the house anymore. So I'm using coconut oil. Okay, so we want to bring this up to a boil in the back. And in the meantime, we want to get our rice kind of toasted. This is 1 cup of jasmine rice. You can use any kind of rice you like. I really like jasmine rice. It's what my grandmother cooked with. So I found it on sale and I bought it. Okay, so I've been cooking the rice probably about maybe 5 minutes now. And you want to keep it moving because you definitely don't want it to burn. But as you can see, it's pretty toasted now. You can see a good bit of brown bit. You just don't want it to get black. I have it about on medium heat. Also to the tomato sauce mixture with the garlic and onion and water, I added 2 teaspoons of the reserved taco seasoning mix from earlier. Turn the sauce down because if you add the rice into boiling sauce, it's going to boil over. You don't want to do that. Gonna stir it for a second and then turn this down. Now my stove, if I turn it on low, it basically turns it off. So I'm gonna put it between the 1 and the 2. Now be careful because this is now hot. But I'm gonna clean up some of this mess and then we're gonna get into stuffing the chimichangas and getting them in the oven. Okay, I can't get this open. So now for the chimichangas, we had the chicken, cream cheese, and taco seasoning mixture sitting in the fridge while I was running errands earlier. Now the recipe from Pinterest says that it's supposed to fill 8. I have 5 tortillas, so I'm going to see if I can fill all of these. So I just have the Aztec flour tortillas. You can get carb balance tortillas, you can get corn tortillas. These are the big kind. Obviously, you just do whatever you want. I preheated my oven to 350 degrees. I have a baking sheet right here that I sprayed with cooking spray. Now, this would be really good if you had maybe some black beans or corn or black bean corn salsa that you could put in here. So if you wanted to add something like that, you totally could. I'm just gonna make mine kind of like little pockets. Keep them kind of small so we can handle them pretty easily. My cameraman said that you couldn't see my pocket folding skills very well, but I'm going to fold in the top, and then I'm going to fold in this side. And they don't have to be perfect. If you're making this for your man, he won't care how they look. Right, baby?
Right.
Okay, so here is all my chimichangas folded up. I was able to fill up 5. I know this one looks kind of weak, but whatever. That was the first one I did, and I was rationing. So then you spray them again with cooking spray. And then you put them in the oven for, hold on. You bake them for 15 minutes, and then when that 15 minutes is up, you flip them over. So that's what we're going to do. Here we go. Okay, just pulled my chimichangas out of the oven. They've been in there for 15 minutes, so now it's time to flip them.
Chimichanga.
Make sure you put them seam side down first. That's probably obvious, but just in case you didn't know that. Back into the oven for another 15 minutes. I want to show y'all my rice. Really don't want to open the lid much, but I'm going to do this for y'all. But as you can see, it's nice and plumped up. Looks like Spanish rice, so that's always a plus. So I'm going to leave the lid off and keep it on here on the between 1 and 2 setting. Just let it dry out a little bit more. So yeah. Okay, I just took the chimichangas out of the oven. They kind of smelled like they were burning, which obviously they weren't. They look pretty. So I went ahead and just took them out. I'm just going to flip them over. We're going to let them cool for a minute. I want to show you guys my rice. Whoa! Camera issues. My cameraman abandoned me. Here's the chimichangas. They look so pretty. Yay! And here is the rice, and it looks so yummy. Okay, guys, I found some shredded cheese in my fridge. I mean, I knew it was in there. Not like I found it and like, oh, I hope this is still good. No, I have some cheese I got out of my fridge. I just put it on a few of the chimichangas. Oh my gosh, what am I talking about? I put it on all the chimichangas, and what I'm going to do is put these back in the oven. My oven is turned off. I'm just going to put them in the oven, in the warm oven, and let that cheese melt, and then we'll eat. Okay, so here's my plate. And Shane's working on his over there. We're going to get his opinion. Oh my goodness. So out of focus. Okay, go.
You gotta pray.
Oh, my bad. We have to say our blessing, y'all. Pause.
That's good.
Take your time. That's probably really hot. I put cheese on. Did you see that?
I did.
Such a big bite. Tell me about it. I haven't even tried it yet. Is it really good?
It is really good.
I guess it's not like a true chimichanga because it has cream cheese and stuff in it, but we like cream cheese. Alright, well, I'm going to eat now because I'm hungry too. Shane approved. It's a good one. Feed it to your men, ladies. Hey guys, so this is the last meal of my 3-meal series from 1 whole fryer chicken. Forgive my appearance. I'm just going to be real with you guys. Thursday, which is today, is cleaning day, and I don't have a lot of time, so this is what you get. I wanted to make chicken and spinach shells. The grocery store I went to did not have shells, so I had to get manicotti, which we like manicotti, and it's the same thing. The only issue with manicotti is it's a little harder to stuff. Now, I have this Pampered Chef Easy Accent Decorator, which I'm going to fill with my filling. And I have this star tip on here. It's the biggest tip in the box. I'll have to refill it several times, but it's the best I could do. I'm going to put a link to Pampered Chef website where you can get one of these. I can't remember how much it is. My mom got this for me. Anyway, I'm going through the ingredients. So I have manicotti. I highly suggest you do the shells because you can stuff them with a spoon.
And then mozzarella cheese. For the sausage, you'll need Alfredo sauce. Now, normally, I make my own Alfredo sauce, but for this, I didn't feel like doing it.
What?
Turn off that Scentsy.
Is it bright?
Yes.
Okay. I also have some spaghetti sauce. Now, lately I've just been buying the can, like the large can of spaghetti sauce, and it's like $1. And I just jazz it up with some garlic, extra Italian seasoning, and some sugar. So this is leftover from another meal we had. So that's going to go in it as well. Then chicken. This is the other bowl of chicken that I had from my whole fryer that I shredded. Ricotta cheese, a block of cream cheese. Nothing healthy about these meals I've made, y'all. I'm going to have to do a whole like series on a healthy makeover thing. But the cream cheese really makes a difference in stuff like this. I have just this thing of chopped spinach. I'm going to show you the easiest way. Now, I microwaved this for 3 minutes, flipping it over halfway through. And this was frozen. So I'm going to show you the best way to get all the liquid out, which you have to get all the liquid out. So this is a dish towel. I got it right out of the drawer. It's clean enough for me. And you just make a little pouch and you spin. That's what your spinach is going to end up looking like once you've gotten most of the liquid out. I've gotten out of your processor. It's just going to be a lot faster. I didn't get to shred my chicken up as much as I want to. And I want my chicken to be pretty shredded in this. I don't want huge gobs of chicken. So I'm going to pulse it so it's really fine. And I've let my cream cheese sit out a little bit. You don't really have to. It just makes it easier. This is also, everything I'm doing right here in this process is stuff that you can do the night before for prep. You have to break your cream cheese up a little bit. And I'm just pulsing. I'm not really letting it go. I'm going to add my ricotta. It's not how you safely hand somebody a knife. Didn't you learn that in school? Now, obviously, this makes a good bit. But if you have any leftover, you can always freeze it. This would be really good to put in like lasagna rolls if you want to do that instead of shells. Like, just boil some lasagna noodles and then roll this up in them and bake it. I've been boiling water as well, as my husband reminded me.
Well, just so they know.
Uh-oh. You can handle this. Okay, now last step. I'm gonna add my bowl of spinach. My poor people. I haven't worked this hard in a long time. That is a mixture, my friends. Yum yum delicioso. So I'm not gonna refrigerate this. I wanted to get it a little soft, that way I can get it into a little easy action thing. Okay, so this is boiling enough for me. I did put some salt in the water. That does help it go a little faster. It gives me 12. It gives me, what is that, 7? 14. Now, you may think you're really going to have a whole bunch of extra stuff, but these manicotti do swell up as they cook. So we will definitely fill them to the brim. Okay, stop that mess. Okay, so I just boiled my noodles at a high boil for only 8 minutes. They're still pretty hard, but that's what you want. You don't want them to be so soft that when you pick them up, you can't handle them. And what I'm doing, I've got a really big, I want to say this is a 9x13, but yeah, I mean, it's Paula Deen size, so it's huge. It's not like a regular Pyrex one where it's kind of rounded. This is square all the way to the bottom. It's one of my favorite pans. Thank you to whoever got this for me when I got married. So I just put my Alfredo sauce down here in the bottom, filled up my mixture, and what I'm going to do, now if you had your shells, all you have to do is have this in here and take a spoon and scoop it out and put it right in your shell. So, okay, is really hard because this mixture is really thick. So once again, I highly suggest you go for the shells. Okay, I'm just going to fill them up that much. Then drop it in your sauce. You decide to be brave and you do the manicotti. Okay, I just got finished stuffing all my shells and I had to maneuver them in there some crazy ways. This is about how much mixture I ended up with extra and the little bit that's in here. So it's not much. You won't waste much. And there's really not much there to do anything with, so I'm going to top it. Okay. Again, best choice, mozzarella cheese. For now, you can be as generous with the cheese as you like. We like cheese. Do we like cheese?
Yes.
Okay, I'm going to cover this with foil now. Since this is early, I'm not going to bake it right now. We eat supper at 6. So I will probably put it into the oven around like 5:15. Let it cook for 15 minutes with the foil on. And then another 10 minutes with it off. So a total of 25 minutes at 350 degrees. I didn't purchase any garlic bread because what Shane and I usually do is we just take regular sandwich bread, put some butter on it, garlic powder, Italian seasoning, put it in the oven, broil it, and that's our garlic bread. I also have already purchased some Sister Schubert rolls from Sunday's meal, so we may just heat some of those up and eat those with it. And I did buy, and this is also on the list.
Okay guys, so this is after I cooked the manicotti in the oven at 350 for 15 minutes covered, 10 minutes uncovered. I did put it on broil probably for about 3 minutes. I like the cheese to get a little bubbly. And you can see we've already plated up, so we're gonna get the man's reaction. I was kind of in a rush, so I did make the easy garlic bread like I had mentioned earlier instead of the Sister Schubert roll. Okay. Be honest.
It's really good.
Is it really good?
It's good. I like it because it's creamy. You can taste all of it, but it's not like overkill with spinach.
How's the Alfredo sauce since it's not homemade? More testing.
It's actually pretty good.
I got the home style, the Prego home style Alfredo, and it seemed, just seemed like the best to me. So here's my plate and our salad. And I'm fixing to eat because I'm hungry.